I don't want to leave this earth yet. I have grandchildren. I want to see what they get up to, what they grow into. I was diagnosed with acute myeloid leukemia, AML, which is a blood cancer. And it was a shock. It was 1:30. I went in and presented at Ballina District Hospital. And I knew something was up because when the doctor came into the room, he actually shut the door. When they shut the door, you know there's a problem. The young doctor, who was wonderful, said, "I'm so sorry, Glenys." He said, "You have acute myeloid leukemia." I just looked at him and I said, "Well, that's not very good. What do we do now?" By 10:30, I was in a hospital bed at Gold Coast University. And then the journey began. The Leukemia Foundation were fantastic. Jay was my Leukemia Foundation coordinator. She arrived on my second day in hospital and informed me about all the facilities that they could offer, like accommodation, finance, travel, things that we hadn't even thought about.
Blood cancer support coordinators are trained healthcare professionals with a variety of backgrounds, for example, nursing, social work, and occupational therapy. We provide support services for patients living with blood cancer and their families. We are the link between hospital systems and patients.
I always liked the thought of having a team behind me because I didn't know what was going to happen to me. And it was just lovely to have someone to talk to who reassured you, had empathy and understanding. So I had a lot of faith all the way through.
I'm honoured that Glenys considers me part of her team. You don't take in all the information that the doctors tell you or other people tell you. So for someone to come in and break it down to be really simple, I think really helps.
The information is so needed because you go in there and you really don't know much about your disease at all. I thought of leukemia as an isolated disease, but now I do know it's a blood cancer and there's so many different types of blood cancer. My husband Greg was in an apartment provided by the Leukemia Foundation. He could visit me every day, which is terrific for my psychological aspect and his too. Without that, you'd probably have to sell your house to pay for some full-time accommodation. It was just amazing. They organised everything. I wanted to be part of a team working together to make me better. They were there to help.
Blood cancers can affect anyone at any stage of life, from children right through to middle age, right through to the elderly. So we need to advocate for people for their care today and to help us to fund research that invests in new treatments and care. There are 135,000 Australians today living with a blood cancer. We think that will double by 2035. So there's a real challenge there about 1% of our population having these diseases that are really, really, really challenging.
I think the solution has to involve better and more intelligent research so that we can ask the questions that will lead to the answers that will make blood cancer a thing of the past.
It's not good enough that people are still dying from blood cancers. We need help to make sure that we find new treatments.
There was Janelle and Doug, and he had the same sort of blood cancer as I did. And they were lovely people, really lovely. He did struggle though, he was sick on and off. Anyway, she rang and she said, "I'm gonna get upset." Anyway, she said, "I'm so glad you're going well." She said, "'cause Doug didn't make it." That was hard. Without research, there are no treatments and no cures. The more we are aware of blood cancer in the community, the more support we can get.
I think it's been amazing what the Leukemia Foundation have done. When I first started out as a blood cancer doctor, as a junior doctor many years ago, there were certain blood cancers that were literally a death sentence. We have seen a revolution, but the revolution needs to continue, and the Leukemia Foundation will lead the way.
Blood cancers are those last really challenging, really difficult cancers. And it's in our blood as the Leukemia Foundation to do more. We have clinicians, researchers, policymakers, donors and supporters all coming together in what we're calling the Blood Cancer Task Force, so that there's a hope, not only for today that people are okay today, but tomorrow there's a treatment for them. We know that today, if you live outside of a metro area, your chances of surviving well from a cancer are lower. That if you live further away from treating centres, a whole raft of factors get in the way. We want everyone across the country to be able to have the best quality care regardless of where they live. We also have business partners, some really long-held partners, incredibly important Australian companies, recognising that working together can help a community organisation like Leukaemia Foundation.
I don't want to leave this earth yet. I have grandchildren. I want to see what they get up to, what they grow into. Another good 20 years would be good.